Hello, and welcome to Time Between Times Storytelling. Here we are again. Snow falls heavily outside. There's a chill in the air, indeed. But we are here for stories at the time when it is neither night nor day, but the sun is gone and the sky is grey. The time when the veil between our world and the fairy world is wafer, wafer thin. So, forget about the cares of the week. Forget about all those things that are bothering you and sit back and relax and listen to a tale traditionally told at the time between times or whenever you choose to listen to it. Okay, today we are going to do something a little bit different. We're going to talk about the tale of Ifor Fach. Ifor Fach and the Lord of Cardiff. Anyone who travels to Cardiff these days, we look upon the hill overlooking the city, and there is the strangest looking castle of all. It is called Castell Coch, and it's like something out of a fairy tale. But many years ago, that castle did not stand there. There was an older castle. The castle called Castell Coch of Senghenydd. And there they lived a Welsh lord called Ifor Fach. As you can imagine, Fach being Welsh for small, he was not a big man, but he had a big heart and a big amount of courage. But let's wait for his tale. Let's imagine that we sat around the fireplace at the time between times. The time when it is neither night nor day, but the sun is gone and the sky is grey. The time when the veil between our world and the fairy world grows wafer, wafer thin. So thin that for just a few moments we can reach into their world, and for a few moments they can reach into ours. That is the time of stories. That is the time that people see lights in the sky. And that is the time of fairies. So sit back, relax, forget that all around us they may be wolves, they may be bears, but we know we are safe here in the time between times. And listen to the tale of Ifor Fach with me, Owen. Almost 1,000 years ago, the Normans came to England. Crossing the sea in their great boats, they landed on the beach of Pevensey and fought a great battle at the Battle of Hastings. Not long after that, they moved into Wales and all over England, and set up their castle in Caerdydd, in Cardiff. And there they ruled over the lands with an iron fist. But one of the old lords of Wales, Ifor Fach, lived in his castle called Castell Coch, which overlooked Cardiff on a great hill. There, with his small amount of men and people, he lived in peace, but always with the shadow of the Norman lord looming over him. One day, whilst he was sat in his hall, having eaten a feast, he received a message from Earl William, the Lord of Cardiff. Earl William said to him that he demanded half of Ifor's lands, half of all his money, half of all his servants, and half of all his treasure, or he would sack the great Castell Coch, the red castle on the hill, and burn it to the ground. Ifor did not know what to do. He was happy in his lands. He did not cause any problems for the Normans. He looked after his people. But now they were threatening him. He knew his army was small and no match for the great Norman lord. So he wondered how on earth he was going to get around this. He thought he could appeal to the king in London, for he knew he would always side with the Norman lord. But then he knew, and he had an idea. He had a cousin called Meirig, who was a great cook. And Meirig was a cook in Earl William's castle. Ifor Fach came up with a plan. He caught some of his most trusted men. And they practiced for ages with rope ladders. And he arranged with the cook, Meirig, that one night, when there was no moon, and when the night was so dark you could barely see your hand in front of your face, they would creep into Earl William's castle. They would kidnap the lord and place him in the dungeon of Castell Coch. And there they would leave him until he agreed to leave the Welsh people alone. It was a bold plan. It was a daring plan. But it was a plan that they would go through with. So they waited until indeed the nights grew so dark that you could not see anything. And there this small party of Welsh warriors rode the winding paths from St. Henydd down to Cardiff. And there they waited by the great wall of the Cardiff Castle that stretched all the way around. They hid themselves and wore the darkest of clothes and crept up against the stone wall, waiting till the moon went behind a cloud. Far away they could hear the church bells ring 12. And then they heard a whistle, which was the signal to enter the inner keep. Ifor Fach flew his ladder over the wall, and he and his men clambered up the stone, jumping down into the inner courtyard. There they ran across the inner courtyard, making sure that no one could see them. And they were met at the keep by Cousin Meirig, who looked at Ifor and said, "Don't worry, I've had a plan. Tonight I have made them turnip soup, but I put something extra in the soup, so all the guards will sleep the sleep of the dead. Don't worry." And then he opened the door to let Ifor into the inner keep. Ifor rushed inside, up the stairs, through the great hall, marvelling at the wonder and the riches that the Norman lords had, until at last he came to the door to the bedroom of Earl William. He pushed it slowly and it creaked open, and he was greeted by the sound of snoring. He looked inside, and there was Earl William and his wife. Rather creepily, Ifor stepped inside and stood over the Earl as he slept, and then poked him until he woke up. The Earl sat up, who, and immediately recognised Ifor. He started to shout, "Guards! Guards!" But Ifor said to him, "You can shout all you want. You will not wake your guards this night." He grabbed the Earl, put him over his shoulder, carried him down the stairs, and they rushed over the courtyard again. Now, because all the guards were sleeping, Meirig opened the gate, and they rushed out of the gate, over the drawbridge, out of Cardiff Castle, and ran to where their horses were kept. As they were running, they heard the bells ringing and the guards waking from their slumber. But Ifor had a head start. They jumped on their horses and rode from Cardiff up the winding road back to St. Henydd. And there they placed Earl William in the deepest dungeon, in the darkest room, and they kept him there. It was only after a couple of days that the Earl promised on his life that he would never harm the people of St. Henydd again. He promised on his life that Ifor Fach could keep his castle, keep his lands, keep his people. And only then was he released and made to walk the winding road to Cardiff back on his own, without a horse. And true enough, he left the people of Cardiff alone for many years after. And Ifor Fach became a legend in those parts. Ifor Fach, the small man with a big heart and stacks of courage, became a legend. Many years after, hundreds of years after the castle collapsed and fell to the ground in ruin, a great Victorian folly now stands there. But every time you pass it, may you be reminded of the courage of Ifor Fach and his daring plan to kidnap Earl William of Normandy to look after his own people. And there we have it, the story of Ifor Fach. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it just for a few moments took you out of your world and into the land of stories. Please consider subscribing. It helps me a lot, and it makes me think that I'm not just talking to myself, which I sometimes feel that I am. And if you'd like to leave a comment, I would really appreciate it. If you want to follow me on Twitter, that would be fantastic. It's Owen S. Griffiths. Strange, I know. I'm Owen Staton. I'm a storyteller. I hope you've enjoyed our brief stay at the Time Between Times. I will see you again soon. Take care. No star.